over time and throughout the summer, we've had a chance to spend a lot of time together, one-on-one in my office. We went off grounds and did some things together. And I think I have an understanding of where they're at and a starting point of which, once we get into conditioning in the fall and lifting and things that we need to do, a point that we can move forward from. You know, we obviously have a lot of work to do to continue to get to know each other, to understand what we need to do to get better collectively and individually. And so it's going to continue to be an ongoing process.
Sean with seven, with six, the crossover. Singletary inside, throws it up, missed the follow. He got it! Singletary the follow with 1.7!
We have a group of some very good young guys that I think are going to be willing workers and want to do well for themselves and for each other. And so I'll maintain that as I did very early on. Trying to get them to understand really what it takes and what they have to give of each other in order to become a solid unit. And I think having them understand that process is, I think, one of my biggest chores.
The Cavs still have a little magic left. 25-second shot clock off. Singletary, the crossover. Sean wants the three. Boom!
No, he hit it again.
From the end of August until the middle of October, we'll have 6 or 7 weeks to kind of get acquainted. And for me, it's very important because that's the first time that I'll really have hands-on day-to-day interaction with them. And so, you know, we'll do the normal things that a lot of schools do and get into the weightlifting and conditioning and get them mind and body ready to go for October. But I think because the NCAA allows us 2 hours a week to get into skill development, that will be critical to introduce some of the things that will be important to our program. To be part of the last ball here in U-Haul and close it out the right way. I've talked to several former players that are excited to come back and be a part of this closing of this building, and that will mean a lot to our program, mean a lot to me personally. And then, as you mentioned, going into the John Paul Jones Arena, in a word, is phenomenal. The times that I've been through there, sitting down and talking with the architects and, you know, just coming up with the Taj Mahal of buildings in America is putting us in a light that this university has not seen to this point. And so it's really gotten me excited. It's gotten our staff and our players excited. But most importantly, when we go out and sell our university to potential recruits, it's gotten them excited as well. You have to get somebody who, at his core, is a very good person, who's willing to learn and accept teaching, accept coaching, and has a desire to get better and better. And I think that will never change. Obviously, as you mentioned, the athletic part of it speaks for itself. Somebody that can come here and excel from an athletic standpoint or a skill standpoint. But we look a whole lot more into the personality, the family background, and things that will allow them to get better at what we're going to ask them to do.